Hey guys, what's up? It's TerraDog. Welcome back to GT Sport, episode 49. So, last time we ran the most expensive race. Today, I guess you could say we're running the cheapest race. We're running a one-make with a Honda Beat. This classic K car has been upgraded to about 84 horsepower. Actually isn't bad for a car that weighs about 3/4 of a ton. The mid-engine layout makes it feel nice and snappy as well. Let's see. The LSD has been upgraded to make it a little stronger when putting the power down on the corner exits. So you still have to kind of feed the throttle a little bit. But, you know, it's only 84 horsepower, so it's not that much that you have to worry about it. Transmission has been upgraded to a race transmission. And gear ratio is tweaked to for a theoretical top speed of about 118 miles an hour. And I'm assuming that's to keep the racing fast enough to be interesting and to keep the 8-shifter guys from having an unfair advantage just by being able to use a clutch faster than what the gate would normally allow you to do with pedal shifters. So, let's get into the qualifying and see how that goes. You got two races for today. And I'm trying to do it without counter steer assist. I'm not sure it can be done. Okay, so the lap record you see on your right side of the screen is actually the lap that was used for qualifying in the races you are going to see. Unfortunately, the game crashed between the time that I set that lap and when I did my first race, and so that footage was not saved, it was lost. So we're going to take a look at a slightly better lap instead. Now that was a mess. I touched that curb at the wrong angle. Thing is, I have to have 80 miles an hour when I climb the hill, or else there's no advantage. Wait, what? I mean, that was sloppy at the end there, but... Are you kidding me? Let's go for a 212.
The mid-engine layout makes it feel nice and snappy as well. Come on. Great. I screwed myself on that one. Though I expected him to, you know, give the space that I gave him, and he did not. More speed than I should have there. And stay with him. Yeah, I screwed that up. But closing in. Alright, final lap. Careful here. And I screwed up. All right, not bad. That was intense. Maybe see if I can win one. Oh man. I very nearly had it, but in that the tricky section, that chicane, I lost sight of where I was trying to aim at. I was focusing on the cars ahead instead. My line got a little sloppy. I lost a lot of momentum. and the gap just doubled in length. If it weren't for that, I might have had a chance. That was awesome. At least I have someone to draft now. Come on, get back in that draft. It's hard to take the corner slower than normal. Hairpin gets me every time.
little too eager on the throttle. That's good. Use your feet to steer. Come on. He's still pulling away. Even through the chicane, we're still not fast enough. Ah, dang it, that mid-shift is gonna screw me. Well, not any more than being behind already was. Alright. Yeah, I keep hesitating exiting that hairpin. Yeah, he's just getting dragged around by that A-house, that top 10 driver or whatever. It's forcing him to figure out how to drive faster, and I'm not close enough to make any use of that. That's the kind of race I wanted to have, was the kind Smith & Wesson had. Oh well. Man, that was quick. And I actually did manage to pull off that 212. So here we go with that. Check out the speed in this sweeping corner. I did not drop below 89. And coming down into this technical section, I believe that's where I made up a lot of time. Not quite as fast as I would have liked, but still faster than what I had been doing. And what also really helped was up here in this hairpin. I make sure to cut down the hesitation on the exit. About 6 tenths faster at that split than my usual pace. Catching some air over the curb.
Made sure not to mess up my final corner. And 212.734 across the line. Alright, that's going to be it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you guys next time. Goodbye.